إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة نرجو بها النجاة يوم العرض عليه وأصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه إخوة الإيمان أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى فقد فاز المتقون. Brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah ta'ala, today as we have embarked on the last 10 days of Ramadan, I would like to remind us of an aspect that is so important in our lives, not just as human beings, but rather as believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is taking care of our hearts. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in a hadith narrated by Abdurrahman ibn Sakhr al-Dawsi, qala anin nabiyy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qal, inna allaha la yanzuru ila suwarikum ولا إلى أموالكم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in this hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala neither looks at our physical appearance nor our properties or our wealth, but he looks at our hearts and our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our physical appearance, whether you come from this tribe or whether you are red or black or blue or whatever color. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is interested in our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is interested in the fruits of our hearts, and those are the actions, what we do in this life. Are we living consonant to what he has prescribed in the Quran, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us in the ahadith, or we are living based on our whims, you know, our desires, wal-iyadu billah. And this is the first hadith to show that it is so important that we take care of our hearts and we make sure that they are pure. The second hadith narrated by Nu'man ibn Bashir radiyallahu anhu, qala sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, innal halala bayyinun wa innal harama bayyinun. And this is instructive that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that surely al halal bayyin, halal is very clear. Halal is very clear, and today we are not suffering from lack of information. In fact, if anything, we are suffering from infobesity. We have too much information. Whereas the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they did not have so much information the way that we have today, and they were closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than we are. And today we know so much. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, innal halala bayyin wa innal harama bayyinun wa baynahuma umurun mushtabihat. And between these two, al halal and al haram, umurun mushtabihat, there are things that are doubtful. You know, many people do not know that this is, whether this is halal or this is haram. Then he says, and huna جَاءَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ بِشَرْطِ. You know, conditional sentence. He says, مَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبُهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ. Anyone who falls into these doubtful matters will fall into haram. كَالرَّاعِ يَرْعَى حَوْلَ الْحِمَى يُوشِكُ أَنْ يَرْتَعَ فِيهِمْ. It is similar to a ra'i, a shepherd, who has taken his animals close to a sanctuary, close to a place that he is prohibited to take his animals to. And what will happen is that surely the animals are going to go into, you know, an area that is prohibited. كَالرَّاعِ يَرْعَى حَوْلَ الْحِمَى يُوشِكُ أَنْ يَرْتَعَ فِيهِمْ. And then he says, أَلَا وَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَلِكٍ حِمَى. Every king has his sanctuary. And the sanctuary of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maharimuhu, is things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. The things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited, if my heart and your heart is not pure, then surely we are going to fall into this haram. And again, I repeat this, the conditional sentence here, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man waqa'a fi shubuhati waqa'a fil haram. Anyone who falls into these doubtful matters will surely fall into haram. Wal'iyadu billah. Ala wa inna fil jasadi mudgha. Every human being has a piece of flesh. Idha saluhat, saluha al-jasadu kullu. Again, we go back to the heart. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that in every human being there is a piece of flesh. If this piece of flesh is pure, then the whole human being will be pure. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ. And if it is impure, if it is evil, then the human being will be an evil human being. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Again, to show the importance of taking care of our hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in my looks. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in what I have amassed of wealth, properties, you know, children and wives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only interested, is my heart pure? Illa man ata Allah biqalbin salim. Except the one who goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or meets his Lord with a pure heart. And then we also know from the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he legislated or he called us to sacrifice, he says, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا. That the meat that you have slaughtered or the blood that you have spilled, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested in this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is interested, وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. What reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from me and you? يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. He wants that consciousness that yes, you submitted and fully submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, this is simply why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to fast during the holy month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, which a verse again we all know, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Just that you have that consciousness. You know, you be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahimahullahu ta'ala tells us that the human being, he says iman. Iman has a sweetness. Iman has a taste. And this test, you know, is found, or, you know, you test it. The sense, you know, is on the, you know, in the heart. Iman is tested by the heart. Just like a human being, when you eat food, mashallah, you have your sense, you know, you eat food, you feel, mashallah, it has, you know, sweetness, or it has sugar, it is bitter, it is sour. And then he says, as similar to that test that you have when you're eating food, if your soul or if your heart is weak or it has a disease, just like when you're sick and you're trying to eat some food and you find it, you know, tasteless, you cannot test whether it is bitter, sour or sweet. Similarly, today, if you are fasting, if you are observing, you know, different rituals that are supposed to draw you to closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you do not find the test, the halawat al-iman in whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed, then know that your heart has a disease. And the way to purify that is, inshallah ta'ala, what we are going to talk about in the second khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he tells us, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلًا. That when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited this verse, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ ما آتوا وقلوبهم وجلة أنهم إلى ربهم راجعون. And those who do whatever they do, they have done whatever they have done, and yet, despite of whatever they have done, قلوبهم وجلة, their hearts are full of fear, anxiety, they are fearful. Why? أنهم إلى ربهم راجعون. They know that they are going to be accountable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Aisha radiallahu anha, when she had this verse recited by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she thought to herself and she questioned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She inquired, does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refer or mean those people who have committed zina? Those people who have stolen? Those people who have committed, they have drunk alcohol? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told her, "La yabnat as-siddiq." No, it is not this that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to in the Quran. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to someone who has prayed, someone who has given in charity, someone who has fasted. And despite the fact that he has fasted, he is fearful. Perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not accepted my fast. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not accepted my qiyamul layl. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not accepted my prayer. And here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam tells us that maybe two men are standing side by side in salah, in saful awwal, and one of them, mashallah, has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the other one has not been accepted. Why? Again, we go back to the heart. It is so important that we purify our hearts. It is so important that we do tarbiyah to our hearts, that inshallah ta'ala, they become pure, and not just think of this physical. You know, we look at the appearance, mashallah, someone is fasting, the appearance that somebody, mashallah, is praying, he has given this, but has this ibadat, have they been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If indeed we were like this, the verse that comes after this, أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ, these are the ones who make haste to do more. Why? It is like looking at the law of probability. Let me do, mashallah, as much as I can, that perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept some of this. You come with numerous ibadat. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it. And this is why we are also taught that when you fast during the holy month of Ramadan, you should now increase. After the holy month of Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala, you fast sitta to shawwal, you fast on Mondays and Thursdays, and you protect your fast. You protect your fast. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of one abstaining from his food and drink if his eyes are not fasting, his ears are not fasting, his tongue is not fasting, his limbs are not fasting. You engage in haram, wal-iyadu billah. Wal-iyadu billah. In purifying our hearts should be our topmost agenda, insha'Allah ta'ala. Because without this, maybe someone will go in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that there are people who are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the ibadat kajibali tihama, like the mountains of tihama. And what will happen? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept their a'mal. Why? Because إِذَا خَلَوْا, when they are in private, they are not seen by any other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, انْتَهَكُوا مَحَارِمَ اللَّهِ, they go and break, you know, everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited them from doing, from engaging in. They would go and watch pornography, listen to music, and what have you, wal-iyadu billah. So let us be careful that inshallah ta'ala, as we are fasting today, our hearts are purified. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed for us to fast so that we attain God consciousness, that, you know, purity of the heart, that we are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تولوا عنه وأنتم تسمعون أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. الحمد لله الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه والصلاة والسلام الأتمان على أكرم خلق الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى أثره إلى يوم المعاد. إخوة الإيمان، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى، واعلموا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذه العشر الأواخر من شهر رمضان كان يحيي الليل، وما ذلك إلا رغبة في نيل ليلة القدر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, according to a hadith narrated by Aisha رضي الله عنها in Bukhari and Muslim, قالت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر أحيى الليل وأيقظ أهله وشد مئزره وجد. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, according to his wife Aisha radiallahu anha, that during this last 10 days of Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would bring to life the last 10 days of Ramadan. He would bring to life the night of these 10 days of Ramadan. أحيى الليل وأيقظ أهله. And he would not just be focused on himself, but rather وأيقظ أهله, and he would also wake up his family. وَشَدَّ مِئْزَرَهُ, and he would tighten his lower garment. A metaphor to either mean that he would exhort himself, he would strive harder, more than the previous 20 days of Ramadan, or that he would keep away from his wives. وَجَدَّ, and he would push himself more. Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala says, similar to, you know, a horse race, or people who are competing, you know, the last stretch, you'd find that, of course, the animal would run faster. And then he says that that animal should not be clever than me and you. That inshallah ta'ala, during this last 10 days of Ramadan, let us emulate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. أحيى الليل وأيقظ أهله وشد مئزرة وجد. That he would strive harder, more than the previous 10 days of Ramadan, the previous 20 days of Ramadan. And this, for us, inshallah ta'ala, we understand, as Sufyan al-Thawri, rahimahullah ta'ala, says, عجباً. It is surprising the affairs of Muslims that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, since he migrated to Medina, he never stopped observing spiritual retreat or the i'tikaf. I am wondering how many Muslims have discarded the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And why was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam doing this? So that he gets Laylat al-Qadr inshallah ta'ala. And just like we are given, you know, a bunch of keys, and you're told one of these keys is going to open, you know, a door to treasures, mashallah, troves of treasures. Would it be prudent for any one of us to just pick one and say, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to take my chances? Rather, you take all the keys, that bunch of keys, and try to open, you know, that door. You try, and inshallah ta'ala, definitely one of them is going to open that door. It is the same example with me and you today. Some of us choose, you know, the awtar. The 21st, you come to the mosque. The 23rd, you come to the mosque. The 25th, you come to the mosque. The rest, you don't come. And if you are to just focus on the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and of course this difference of opinion is there, you know, in the books of fiqh, it did not start with us, the qadis and the others. It did not start with us. So definitely, when it is 23rd, according to some, it is 22nd according to others. So this should just call us to, you know, strive during the whole, you know, 10 days or the last 10 days of Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala. So this is just a reminder to me and you that inshallah ta'ala, let us not peak. I am going to strive harder during this night, and the subsequent or the following night I am going to relax. No, rather strive harder inshallah ta'ala during the last 10 days of Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala. And then why did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do i'tikaf? Ibn Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala says, the heart in its journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is held back by, you know, inshighalat, by things. And among them is excessive eating. Among them is excessive, you know, mingling with brothers and sisters and friends and relatives. And among them is kathratu al-nawm, al-akl, wa-shurb, wal-ikhtilat. So you excessively engage, you know, either in eating, in sleeping, in talking. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed for us the holy month of Ramadan. When you fast, mashallah, you abstain from dawn to dusk from, you know, eating and drinking and other desires. So alhamdulillah, your heart, you know, becomes collected and it is focused now on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. During the last 10 days of Ramadan, when you sit in the mosque and you leave kathratu al-kalam, wa kathratu al-ikhtilat, you know, excessive, you know, talking, excessive mingling with brothers, you know, you're going here, qiyamun nahar, some of us, they engage in qiyamun nahar. Qiyamun nahar, as one of the preachers says, you know, you go to the malls and you're just walking, window shopping, just wasting time, wal-iyadu billah. He calls this qiyamun nahar. And how many of us are engaged in qiyamun nahar? So whether it is surfing, you know, you're engaging in this, wal-iyadu billah. So during the last 10 days of Ramadan, mashallah, you have abstained from food, drink, you know, from dawn to dusk. When you do itikaf also, now you abstain from and you keep away from, you avoid everything that is going to preoccupy you from your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, inshallah ta'ala, is the sirr. It is a secret to al-i'tikaf, that when you sit and engage or observe this, you know, retreat, you sit and you only think and contemplate of, you know, how you're going to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You reflect on, you know, your sins and your future. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward you. Again, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala says in this verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورُ لِيُوَفِّيَهُمُ اللَّهُ. That in this verse, the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ Shakur, that verily those who recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and tilawa, recitation of the Quran, has two meanings. The one that we all understand, alif lam mim dhalikal kitabu la rayba fi, and tilawa simply means that you are following, you know, every letter after the other. So this is recitation. And recitation also means that you are implementing whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you to implement, you know, from the Quran. So inna alladhina yatluna kitab Allah wa aqamu as-salah, verily those who recite the book of Allah and they implement it in their lives, and they observe as-salah, and they give charity, you know, whether it is out in the open or in secret, and they are only seeking the ajr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِيُوَفِّيَهُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will surely reward them. And then he says, إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ Shakur, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gracious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does, you know, shukr. He rewards you
for whatever good that you have done. And this good that you have done, when you commit, or rather when you implement, or rather when you do whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you, you've observed your five obligatory prayers, Allah is shakur, Allah rewards you with peace. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shakur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you with that halawa, the sweetness of iman. If you do not find the sweetness of iman when you are observing as-salah or qiyamul layl, then know that your heart has a disease, wal-iyadu billah. Just like if you are sick, your tongue cannot taste the sweetness of that food. Similarly, if you do not find halawat al-iman in a'mal as-saliha, then know your heart has a disease, wal-iyadu billah. And this calls me and you to continue purifying our hearts and seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man qama ramadana, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. If we observe qiyam during the holy month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us our sins, provided we are doing this إيمانا. It is an act of worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me, and it is an act of worship. And therefore, if it is an act of worship, yesterday I remember as we were doing qiyam, there was a gap, you know, next to me. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man qama ramadana imanan. If it is an act of worship, you do not observe it based on your desires. I don't feel like moving to that space. Where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, wallahi, he swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are going to have, you know, you're going to complete your sufuf or this rose, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to create discord in your hearts. Wal-iyadu billah. So as we are also observing qiyamul layl, we are observing our salawat, let it be imanan, according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us. وَاحْتِسَابًا, we are expecting, you know, thawabs and rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا وَصَلُّوا وَسَلِّمُوا عَلَى خَيْرِ الْبَشِيرِ فَقَدْ أَمَرَكُمُ الْبَارِي بِذَلِكَ حَيْثُ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا وَرَضَى اللَّهُمَّ عَنِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرَ وَعُثْمَانَ وَعَلِيٍّ وَعَنْ سَائِرِ الصَّحَابَةِ أَجْمَعِينَ وعنا معهم بجودك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, وأذل الشرك والمشركين, واحمي حوزة الإسلام يا رب العالمين. اللهم عليك باليهود ومن هاودهم, والنصارى ومن ناصرهم, والشيوعي ومن شايعهم, والمنافقين ومن وافقهم. ربنا تقبل منا صيامنا, ربنا تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وتلاوتنا للقرآن. اللهم أعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا وإخواننا من النار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم, واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم, ولذكر الله أكبر وأولى وأتم. أقم الصلاة.